Caribbean and North Brazil Shelf large marine ecosystems are two of the world's 66 large marine ecosystems, or LMEs. They span an area of marine space of approximately 4.5 million square kilometers and provide a multitude of ecosystem goods and services to human societies. In our assessment and management activities, we refer to the combination of these two ecosystems as the CLME Plus region. This CLME Plus region is shared by 26 countries and 18 overseas territories, many of them being small island developing states, or SIDS. The region probably harbors almost 10% of the remaining coral reefs in the world and around 20% of the remaining mangrove forests. Tourism, fisheries, shipping, and oil and gas are the main drivers of a marine-based economy in this region. In a similar way as has happened with many of the world's LMEs, the CLME Plus region has been severely affected over the past decades by the issues of pollution of the marine environment, the degradation of marine habitats such as coral reefs, mangroves and seagrass beds, and overfishing and unsustainable fishing practices. The negative impacts of these problems on the marine environment and on the human societies that depend on them can easily become further exacerbated now by the effects of climate change. This means that urgent action is required to revert the situation, and given the many countries that share this marine space, collaboration among nations will be key. Collaboration, however, will not only need to be transboundary, but also span the different sectors of government and the different sectors of society. That means government, academia, civil society and private sector will all have to work together in order to revert this degradation. It is in this context, and based upon a request from the CLME Plus countries, that the Global Environment Facility, or GEF, has been supporting the gradual and progressive move towards a region-wide adoption of an ecosystem-based management approach. GEF co-financing was provided for a foundational capacity building project, the CLME project, which ran from 2009 till 2014. Under this project, transboundary diagnostic analysis, or TDAs, were undertaken. The TDAs pointed to weaknesses in national level and transboundary marine resources governance, and lack of awareness in data and information, among other factors, as the main root causes of environmental degradation. Based on these findings, a 10-year strategic action program for the sustainable management of shared living marine resources was collaboratively developed, called the CLME Plus SAP. The particular approach followed by the CLME project consisted of engaging key intergovernmental organizations with a regional mandate on fisheries and on the protection of the marine environment in the SAP development process. This happened on behalf and in representation of the CLME Plus governance. This way, country ownership over the SAP was promoted, and the delivered action program was highly reflective of the regional and national level priorities. To date, the CLME Plus SAP has been politically endorsed by 35 ministers, representing 25 countries and 6 overseas territories from this region. The SAP's 10-year implementation window covers the period from 2015 to 2025, making it very well aligned with strongly related global processes, such as, for example, SDG 14 under the 2030 Sustainable Development Agenda, and the Aichi targets under the Convention on Biological Diversity. The region-wide political support for the action program resulted in renewed financial support from the GEF through the 5-year UNDP CLME Plus project. This new project aims at catalyzing the implementation of the SAP, as it recognizes that it would be impossible to fully implement such an ambitious action program through a single project or initiative. For that reason, whereas the CLME Plus project does aim to implement some of the key actions under the SAP, it also puts much emphasis on creating collaborative alliances among the many organizations and stakeholders with an interest in the marine environment in the CLME Plus region. Whereas the project is being executed through a regional project coordination unit established by the United Nations Office for Project Services, UNOPS, on behalf of the United Nations Development Programme, UNDP, many of the activities under the project are being delegated to those organizations with a long-term mandate or widely recognized competitive advantage relating to the management of marine environment in the region. This includes both governmental bodies, as well as NGOs and academic institutions. This approach is taken to ensure continuity of project outcomes beyond the project lifespan, and to further help strengthening those stakeholders with a long-term role in the protection and sustainable use of the marine environment in the region. By doing so, the CLME Plus project also fully exploits and further builds on the governance mechanisms that have already been put in place, and strives to further enhance and complement them and fill in any remaining gaps. The project strongly promotes the vision of one UN by engaging several UN organizations such as UNDP, UNOPS, FAO, UNEnvironment, each working within the fields of their respective mandates in a well-coordinated way. Major efforts are now being dedicated to forging a global alliance and partnership for the protection, sustainable management and use of the CLME Plus region. This multi-stakeholder partnership, engaging governments, civil society and private sector, will be centered around an interim coordination mechanism consisting of the 8 intergovernmental organizations with a core mandate on the marine environment for the region. In order to track progress and support further decision-making, an integrated reporting mechanism called State of the Marine Environment and Associated Economies will also be developed, linking actions to protect the marine environment to the development of a sustainable blue economy for this wider Caribbean region. For more information, documents and tools related to the CLME Plus project, the SAP and the Global Partnership, we invite you to visit the CLME Plus Hub at www.clmeplus.org.